Hi guys, it is just a nasty, yuck, gray, depressing day here in the end times, and do I dare say the word paradise, of Garfield, Texas, here on Saturday morning, November 10th, 2018. But as I say, since I'm not in paradise, California, I guess I will not complain about the weather or anything else in my little slice of paradise in Garfield, Texas. And so anyway, you're probably assuming the story out of Paradise, California will be my We Are So Fucked story of the day. I notice it is the number one story on Yahoo News at this minute, the absolute, literally, hell that paradise has turned into. There, of course, they're already using the paradise lost meme, which will be all over the place. But anyway, I think I'm going to turn that story over to, because it's just too easy on one level, for the We Are So Fucked headline of the day. I'm going to turn that over to my little milquetoast twin over there at Collapse Chronicles, and I'll visit that story as the example of the collapsing planet story of the day. You know, it's hard, you know, to try to figure out. I basically go through two stories a day. The We Are So Fucked versus the Collapsed Chronicle. So we're going to put Paradise, California in the Chronicle of the Collapse. And right over here on Humptydumptytribe, we're going to go over to the shithole country of China. There are so many dots, We Are So Fucked dots, and levels of, good God, everything from bullshit. And this story from good old Time magazine, talking about something I was completely unaware of. Never heard of Singles Day. Have you ever heard of the term Singles Day? And suddenly, something I have never heard of, here in Time magazine, making the We Are So Fucked headline of the day. How Singles Day grew to be the world's biggest shopping event. Singles Day 2018, the biggest shopping event of the entire year, is right around the corner. Not Black Friday, but Singles Day, which arrives in China on Sunday, meaning tomorrow, with door-busting deals for savvy shoppers. The holiday was inaugurated by Chinese e-commerce giant Alibaba in 2009 and has since gone to outpace Black Friday as the single largest sales day in the world. Last year, Singles Day hit a record $25.3 billion in sales, which is double Black Friday and Cyber Monday combined. Jesus. Its origins stretch all the way back to 1993, when students at China's Nanjing University bought presents for themselves to celebrate their singlehood and resist social pressure to get married. The single students chose November 11th as their Valentine's Day. So this is purely to buy presents for yourself. These days, Singles Day is still about treating yourself, whether or not you have someone to share your new loot, and it is now also gone global. Alibaba has rebranded Singles Day as the 11/11 Global Shopping Festival. And now international brands like Gap, Nike, and Macy's have all joined this orgy of this absolute hedonistic consumerism. We now have fashion shows joining the... Okay. How does Singles Day stack up against Black Friday? Both holidays mark seasons for splurging. Singles Day shopping starts between China's Golden Week in October and the Chinese New Year in February, filling an otherwise slow spell for retailers, while Black Friday and Cyber Monday signal the kickoff for our winter holiday shopping. But they do have some differences, as Singles Day is focused more on limited edition luxury items with less emphasis on steep discounts. Many U.S. shoppers look to Black Friday to indulge on a big purchase like a flat screen TV at discount prices, but Singles Day is also now becoming known for gift exchanges. So now not only are you supposed to buy a present for yourself, but you can buy presents for other singles. Oh, God. All right, here are the numbers. Going by the statistics, there is little contest. Singles Day surged past America's Black Friday and Cyber Monday back in 2012. And has only expanded from there. Alibaba hauled in $25.3 billion alone last year, compared to Black Friday and Cyber Monday, which together raked in only $11.6 billion for the 2 days of sales. But Alibaba is not the only player. The other main player, JD.com, also made $19.1 billion on Singles Day last year. So we're actually talking about 44.4 billion dollars in online sales in 1 day in the country of China. But it's not just China anymore, as shoppers in 225 countries snapped up goods from over 140,000 businesses. At the height of the sales, Alibaba's cloud services processed 325,000 sales transactions per second and delivered a total of 812 million packages last year. In Singles Day 2018, promises to be an even bigger bonanza. Oh, God. Now we have Food services joining the orgy. Singles Day 2018 will be, quote, bigger and more successful than its predecessors. Alibaba is already getting ready. Its logistics firm opened China's largest robotic warehouse and chartered 51 international flights and 1,000 shipping containers to get ready for tomorrow. As Alibaba expects to hit 1 billion sales orders tomorrow. And of course, Singles Day absolutely dwarfing Amazon Prime Day 2018, which only saw 100 million products ordered on Amazon Prime Day, which is a mere minnow compared to Singles Day. And Singles Day is now about far more than sales, with Alibaba and other associated vendors hosting a slew of festivals and special events. Don't forget today's star-studded gala going on as I am speaking that rivals the Super Bowl for spectacle. God. Anyway, guys, if there is anybody who does not understand why Singles Day 2018 is every bit as much as a "We Are So Fucked" headline of the day in Paradise, California, then obviously I am having a failure to communicate. This for anybody wanting to understand why we are so fucked today, you don't need to go to Paradise to find out. But as I say, I'm going to change shirts now, and we will head over to Paradise for our collapse chronicle of the day on that other channel. Come see me over there. And then the little dog and I are going to meet one of our pile of fish. Sancho does have a new girlfriend, and we have a walk scheduled with Sancho's new girlfriend, so I need to get on getting on.
Bye, guys.